Today is the third of Shawwal and the third day of Eid al-Fitr. Alhamdulillah, we are here once again in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to fulfill the command regarding Salat al-Jum'ah al-Mubarakah. Brothers in Islam, today I am going to talk about prayer. It's a reminder for us after Ramadan al-Mubarak. The masajids, they get empty after Ramadan, after Eid. People want to take break from their prayers, especially in a masajid with congregational prayer. But the prayers are the first after accepting Islam, often saying Shahada, believing on oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the prophethood of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The first command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is wa aqimu salat, establish your prayer, offer your prayer, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The purpose of human al-insan is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala day and night, to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala day and night, our Creator, our Lord, our Razik, that one thing that we get, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provides us for, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided for us. So we have to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we don't have to forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the purpose and reason that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in Quran, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I did not create jinn and ins except for my worship. So always that we have to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a day, on different times, in our worship of prayer, giving charity, working on our behavior, stopping ourselves from hasad and jealousy and backbiting, and these all things that are recommended as a human that make us a good human. So we have to work on these things. These all consider worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yani those things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbid them, we have to be far from them. This is a worship. Those things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us in Quran to do them, these are also a worship as well. So we have to be always obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in Quran, wa aqimu salat, establish your prayer, offer your prayer, wa atu zakat, and give the charity, give your zakat, pay your zakat. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us, wa ati'u rasul, then obey your messenger. Wa ati'u rasul, aqimu salat wa atu zakat, then wa ati'u rasul, and offer your prayer, give your zakat, all kind of worship, the worship that you have to do as a abd, as a servant, how you have to do them. وَأَتِيعُ الرَّسُولِ, doing the ittiba' of beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, how he did them, you have to follow the sunnah of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Yani aqimu salat means establish your prayer, establish it that way that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam did it. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam did not only offer prayer just the faraid, just the compulsory, like two fard prayer of Fajr or the fourth rak'ats of Zuhar or Asr, but properly Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was offering the prayer with sunnahs, with those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command, because he did anything except from the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed upon him. So we don't, without any reason, we don't have to. This is ati'ur rasul. Aqimu salat wa atu zakat, when you establish your prayer, when you give zakat, when you give, do any kind of worship, you have to do it on the path, on the way of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not mention how to offer your prayer in Quran. The Prophet did not mention it in Quran anywhere. There is no in Quran that how, when, where, how you have to offer your prayer. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in his hadith to the companions, Sallu kama ra'aytumuni usalli. Offer your prayer, like look at me and how I am offering it. When Prophet was offering it, so the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam offered the sunnahs as well. The sunnahs of Zuhar prayer, and the sunnahs of Asr prayer, the sunnahs of Maghrib prayer, the sunnahs of Isha prayer, the sunnahs of Fajr prayer. So all the sunnahs, the Prophet sallallahu completely he was offering them, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When we offer our prayer, try our best that we have to follow the footsteps, the way the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us. Because the minimum, the faraiza, these are the norms of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to do them. If we don't do them, that we are going to get sin for it. But do them the proper way to get more reward, to be more near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with good way that you can please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we have to care about our sunans and nawafils as well. Those are the things that are going to make us close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are going to make us friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the thing, if we do any kind of mistake in our fara'id, that are going to fulfill them. That are going to, if we do any kind of mistake, any sunnah is going to fill it with any kind of the mistake that we do. So the Prophet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُ الزَّقَاةَ وَأَتِيعُ الرَّسُولَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. That you may receive mercy. If someone wants a mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, أَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُ الزَّكَاةَ وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولِ. Offer your prayer like Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was offering it. لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. If you want to have the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, maybe لَعَلَّكُمْ, maybe you can get the mercy of Allah with this way if you follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is maybe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have a mercy upon you if you follow the way of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the sunnah of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Brothers in Islam, what is mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How that when we offer our prayer, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showers His mercy upon us. In the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, an Abi Hurairah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as-salatul khamsun, وَالْجُمُعَةُ إِلَى الْجُمُعَةِ وَالْرَمَدَانُ إِلَى رَمَدَانِ مُكَفِّرَاتٌ لَمَّا بَيْنَهُنَّ إِذَا اجْتُنِبَتِ الْكَبَائِرِ. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you offer your five daily prayers from first prayer till the second prayer, it's going to be the kafara between those prayers from Fajr till Zuhar prayer. If you do any kind of mistake, any kind of minor sin, so this is going to be mukaffirat, expiation for it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to remove that sin because you offered your Fajr prayer. Then you are planning to offer your Zuhar prayer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is the mercy of Allah. لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. This is the mercy of Allah, that because you are praying, you offered, you obeyed Allah. Now you are going to thinking that I'm going to offer my Zuhar prayer. So this is the mercy of Allah, that first prayer till the second prayer, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to remove your sin, the expiation. This is going to be a kafara. This is going to be a kafara. This is going to be kind of, you know, it's going to remove for it. And from one prayer to other prayer. Then the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is وَالْجُمُعَةُ إِلَى الْجُمُعَةِ. From one Jumu'ah till the other Jumu'ah. You offer your this Jumu'ah, then made your intention that inshallah I'm going to offer the other the second Jumu'ah, the next Jumu'ah as well. So this is going to be a kafara for you. This is لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. The way of our beloved Prophet, you can offer it. So this is going to be a kafara from one prayer to the second prayer, and from one Jumu'ah to the second Jumu'ah. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned it more. وَالْرَمَدَانُ إِلَى رَمَدَانُ. If you offered your prayer in the month of Ramadan, offer your all ibadat, salatul tarawih, and at the day you fasted. So that are going to be a kafara for you from one Ramadan till other Ramadan. And this is the mercy of Allah upon beloved Prophet, Ummah of beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the mercy of Allah. Do little bit, you will get more reward. Do little bit, you are going to get more reward. But you don't have to just forget. Allah doesn't want us to be always that we are worshipping. Worshipping means that we can worship, but we don't have to forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We don't have to be always in masajid. We have to be at the time of prayer. If at the time of classes or anything or any program, but you have to make your intention, offer your prayer in the masjid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Masajid is plural of masjid. Masjid means the place of the sajda. Is sajda yasjudu? Masjid is that place that you can do the sajda, that's called masjid. It's from sajda. The place of sujood is masjid. The place of sujood is masjid. So from Ramadan ila Ramadan. Lamma baynahunna. What is between them? Between one Ramadan to other Ramadan. Between one Jum'ah to other Jum'ah. Between one prayer to other prayer. These are all mukaffirat. They are going to be a kafara for them. Izajtunibat al-kabair. And with one condition, you have to protect yourself from the kaba'ir, from great sins. Those sins that are categorically mentioned in the Quran and the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, be far from them. Those kind of, because the hurma is from Quran. The hurma is from Quran. Ya ayyuhal lazina amanu, innamal khamru wal maysiru wal ansabu wal azlamu rijsum min amal shaytan. Fajtanibu. In here, ijtinab. You have to, the kabair, the great sins, that you have to be far from them. Then Prophet is giving guarantee, if any kind of mistakes you do between them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to consider them as a kafara, because your intention was good, you are making your prayer, you are remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are offering your prayer, so everything is going to be good. In one condition, izajtunibat al-kabair, you have to be far from the kabair. Kabairs are those things that categorically, clearly Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned them in Quran and the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Brothers in Islam, in another hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, وَإِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ الرَّجُلِ مَعَ الرَّجُلِ أَسْقَى مِنْ صَلَاتِهِ وَحْدَهُ. If you offer your prayer by yourself individually, so if you offer it with a person, a second person, that is better that you are offering it by yourself. That's going to be more azka, more pure. You are going to get more reward. It's going to be the tazkiyah of your nafs more than when you offer it with someone else, with two persons. Instead of one, try to make a jama'ah, make it with two persons. So that is more, going to be more azka, more pure for a person. When instead of just offering it individually, when you are at your home, you are late from the jama'ah, you are at your home, try your best to offer your prayer with your son, with your kid, with your wife, so that with this way they are going to learn as well. You are going to get the reward of jama'ah as well, and also see, you are going to follow this hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَصَلَاتُهُ مَعَ الرَّجُلَيْنِ أَسْكَى مِنْ صَلَاتِهِ. If you offer your prayer with two people, and including you, it's going to be three. That is more pure, أَسْكَى. With two, then you can make it more with the three. مَعَ الرَّجُلِ. وَمَا كَسُرَ فَهُوَ أَحَبُّ إِلَى اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. If you be with a more than three, that is the more that in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah loves this thing that when you are going to offer your prayer in congregational prayer. In the congregational prayer, when you offer your prayer, how many people are going to get more? That much you are going to get reward, that much is going to be more pure and azka. This is good for your tazkiyatun nafs as well. So you can try your best to offer your prayer with congregational prayer. Especially after Eid, that in the masajids, on Facebook, I saw a few pictures that, you know, the imams or someone put, they said now after Ramadan, see there are two, three people or four, five people, they are coming for offering prayer. Say, see the masajids now. So alhamdulillah, you know that the prayer is fard on us. This is the remembering of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is going to make us punctual in our time. This is going to get us to always we have to be clean. We have to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is, and get the rahmah of. And this is that kind of thing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أن رسول الله sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, الملائكة تصلي على أحدكم ما دام في مصلاه الذي ما لم يحدث. If someone's offer prayer, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so he is just on that place that he offered prayer, the malaika, the angels, they do supplication for that person. Do dua, the malaika, it's the duty of angels and malaika, when you are offering your prayer, after that you are sitting on that place, remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, doing dua, doing tasbihat, subhanallah, Allahu Akbar, alhamdulillah, astaghfirullah, just extra effort, you're begging to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you. So since that you are sitting there, the malaika is doing dua for you. And what is the dua of malaika? The beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allahumma ghfir lahu, Allahumma arhamu. They said, Allahumma ghfir lahu, oh Allah forgive this person. They just remember you. They were of akimis salata li dhikri. Establish your prayer to remember me. They were just, remembering you. Ya Allah, forgive them. Allahumma ghfir lahu. Warhamhu, Ya Allah, have mercy upon them. Have mercy on that person that he just offered prayer. The malaika, the angels, they offer prayer. They do the supplication. They do dua for that person. Brothers in Islam, especially the Fajr prayer and the Isha prayer. That's a long hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This the hypocrite, it's a very burden upon a hypocrite, especially the Isha prayer and Fajr prayer. If someone offers his Isha prayer with Jama'ah, he is going to get the reward of half night that he was worshipping, standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If someone make it with Fajr, so it all, like this is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon Ummah of beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All night that he is worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All night, if you offer your prayer in congregational prayer, Isha and Fajr prayer, brothers in Islam. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in another hadith, أَلَا أَدُلُّكُمْ مَا يُكَفِّرُ اللَّهُ بِهِ الْخَطَايَ وَيَزِيدُ بِهِ الْحَسَنَاتِ قَالُوا بَلَا يَا رَسُولَ قَالَ إِسْبَاغُ الْهُدُوعِ عِنْدَ الْمَقَارِ وَكَسْرَةُ الْخُطَى إِلَى الْمَسَاجِ وَعِنْدَ الصَّلَاةِ وَإِنْتِزَارُ الصَّلَاةِ بَعْدُ الصَّلَاةِ. If someone offers his the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I can tell you something that's going to help you a lot. That's going to help you a lot. You have to, do your ablution properly. If it's a little bit hard for you, but think that it's a worship, it's a ibadah, it's a command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we can do it. And also that more often you have to go to masajid and wait from one prayer to other prayer, this that you are going to be successful. You are going to be successful. So brothers in Islam, try our best that we can offer our prayer, and we have to, come to masajid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are the places of sajda. In congregational, there are 27 times. In riwayah, 25 times that you can get more reward. Another thing, brothers in Islam, especially we are in the month of Shawwal, there is a hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Sahih Muslim from Sayyidina Abu Ayyub al-Ansari رضي الله تعالى عنه أنه حدثه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من صام رمضان ثم أتبعه. Whoever fasted in the month of Ramadan, in the month of Ramadan, ثم أتبعه من شوال كان كصيام الدهر. If someone fast in the month of Shawwal, in the complete month of Shawwal, 6 days, so the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give him the reward of all year that he was fasting. In another riwayah of Ahmad and Sunan Nisa'i, the Prophet ﷺ explained it that on one fasting you can get 10 rewards. It's the verse of Quran, Man ja'a bil hasanati falahu asharu amsaliha. Falahu asharu amsaliha. Then that if you multiply it, the 30 days multiply, it's going to be 300. 300 days. So 300 days, there's going to be 60 more days. So if someone's fast in the month of Shawwal, 6 more is going to get the reward of 60, is going to be completely the year that he was fasting. This is also a mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon Ummah of beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's not compulsory that you can fast it in one order, but if you want to make it in one order, that's good. It's going to, you're going to finish it quick. But if someone wants in the complete month of Shawwal that they can, you know, 6 fasting, it's a sunnah to fast on Mondays and Thursdays as well, or on the every moon 13, 14 and 15 ayyamul bith. Or if someone has any kind of qada to make up, so they can make the intention of qada, and so they can fulfill their qada and also get the reward of the fasting of Shawwal as well. So try your best if you can. It's a recommended, it's a mustahab amal, and the friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the scholars, they recommend that you have to fast the 6, you know, it's mentioned in the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Sahih Muslim. Try your best that you have to fast at least the 6 fast, or you can make your habit on Monday and Thursday, or that, you know, ayyamul bid, so you're going to get the reward. If you have a qada, if the sisters, they have qada, so they can make their qada with these Shawwal days, so they can get more rewards as well, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to offer our prayer on time in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa ma alayya illa al-balagh.